Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. In this tutorial, we're going to copy this wall down to the BS level so that we can get a normal height for the guest toilet under the staircase. Go to the 3D view and click the front view. Click into this area to get a window selection and move the mouse cursor approximately half the windows to select them. Go to the bottom of the screen and click the sunglasses. Select hide element. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. So we are going to deal with these walls. Now select this wall for the moment and the door. Go to the view and click the down arrow. Select hide element. We want to use this area as the guest toilet, so we need to align the foundation wall to the wall of the kitchen wall. To do that, go to the modify tab and select the align command. Click the face of this wall and zoom in and click the face of this wall. This wall shifts to the wall to align with the wall of the kitchen. When the wall shifts, it shifts together with the footing. Select the face of this wall and click the face of this foundation to shift it to the other side. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Click the reveal hidden elements button and select the wall that you hide recently and click the hide element to bring it back. Click this X button to return to your drawing. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Now select this wall, change the base constraint, click the down arrow and select the BS level. Move the mouse cursor to drawing area to see the results. Press escape to deselect the wall. Click on the sunglasses and click reset. Click the reveal hidden elements button and select the door. Click on hide elements and click this X to bring the door to the drawing. Now select the door and move the door to the BS level. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the ground floor plan and zoom in into this area. Let's go and draw the staircase. Now right click the reference plane and select create similar. Click the pick line button and in the offset panel enter 9 feet 3.5. Offset the reference plan to this area. Press escape to deselect the reference plane. Now select the door and notch the door to the right until it crosses the reference plane. Right click the reference plane, grid similar, select the pick line button. For the offset distance, enter 2.5 inches. Offset this line, select this wall and offset up, and select this wall and offset down. Now go to the architectural tab, circulation panel, and click the steer command. In the property palette, make sure that the assembly 7 maximum rise 11 thread is checked. Click the edit type button and change the maximum riser to 7 inches and the maximum thread depth to 11 inches. The maximum width to 3 feet. Click OK. Change the justification by clicking the down arrow and select left. Start the stairs from this point. Move the mouse cursor, hold down the mouse wheel and pan, and look at the text. When it reads 11 created, 7 remaining, click. Move the mouse cursor into the opposite direction. Try to align these stairs at the end of the other stairs you created at the bottom. Click and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Now select this landing and click this arrow to move it backward. When you're satisfied with what you see, click the green check mark to end the stair command. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Select this wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Click the X button to create the default 3D view. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the section command. Click from this point to this point to draw a section plan. Press escape. Right click the section plan. Right click the section bubble and go to view. Now select this wall. Click this endpoint and move the wall down at the bottom of the landing. Click out to deselect the wall. Click the X button to close this view. Click the default 3D view. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to see the result. Select this railing and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this railing, go to the property palette and try different railings. Let's try the guardrail type and see the result. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to experiment your model. Alright, let's stop this tutorial here. In the next video, we are going to model the slab for this project. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.